Some people find it hard to reconcile the concept of God's wrath with what they perceive to be the character of God. Sa madaling salita, yung idea ng pagkapuot ng Diyos o puot ng Diyos, God's wrath, okay? Minsan mahirap tanggapin o arukin, you know, ng mga tao, especially kapag iniisip nila, no, na ito ba ay consistent sa character of God. In other words, you know, if God loves us, how can He judge us? But saan natin ilalagay yung wrath na yon sa character of a loving God? So, para sa marami, o ilan, I think for several people, God's wrath is inconsistent with His loving, kind, and merciful character. No? Hindi nila ma-reconcile yung dalawang idea of God's love as well as God's wrath, no? It's either one or the other, di ba? Kasi iniisip nila, if God is loving, no, di maawain siya sa lahat ng tao, no? And especially sa mga tao na mababait, di ba? So it cannot be both. Thus, for many people, parang na-stumble sila doon sa idea of God's wrath. Parang it's so out of character with God. Pero God's wrath is not contrary to His character, as we are about to learn. So our passage today is Romans 3 verses 1 to 8, and Paul is advancing yung kanyang argument, no, concerning the universal need of everyone, both Jew and Gentile, everybody else, kasama tayo, for salvation, you know. Because we are all guilty. We are all separated from God. And we are unable to fulfill His will. Kahit sino pa tayo, there are no exceptions whatsoever. Pero, you know, as Paul is arguing his case, you know, even before he can tell us about the good news of the gospel, he's continuing to deal with various objections. And in this particular passage, Romans 3, 1 to 8, you know, he's dealing with the objection of basically, gaya ng sinasabi ko kanina, mga pious Jews, mga Jews who are trying their best to live for God, you know, and they're saying na basically, kung isusuma natin, sasummarize natin, parang hindi yata consistent sa faithfulness and love ni Lord itong sinasabi mo, Paul, you know? Or parang pinalalabas mo, Paul, na kaming mga Hudyo, parang wala nang mga pangako sa amin ng Panginoon, no? So, Paul is going to deal with those objections. And so, let's read yung passage, no? Starting in verse 1 of chapter 3. And let's read. What advantage then is there in being a Jew? Or what value is there in circumcision? Much in every way. First of all, they have been entrusted with the very words of God. What if some did not have faith? Will their lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? Verse 4, not at all. Let God be true and every man a liar, as it is written, so that you may be proved right when you speak and prevail when you judge. Verse 5, but if our unrighteousness brings out God's righteousness more clearly, what shall we say? That God is unjust in bringing His wrath on us? I am using a human argument. Certainly not. If that were so, how could God judge the world? Verse 7, someone might argue, if my falsehood enhances God's truthfulness and so increases His glory, why am I still condemned as a sinner? And then verse 8. Why not say, as we are being slanderously reported as saying, and as some claim that we say, let us do evil that good may result. Their condemnation is deserved. Ayan. So we want to understand the words of the Apostle Paul. So let's pray. Ngi tayo ng gabay at tulong sa ating Panginoon. Father, we praise you and thank you that today once more you have invited us into your presence. We now pray, Lord, na tulungan niyo po kami. Lahat po ng mga nakikinig, wherever they might be right now, including myself, guide us, O Lord, as we meditate on your word today. Tulungan niyo kami na maunawaan namin what you are saying to us through the words of the Apostle Paul in this scripture that we just read. Help us to understand and see how ano ang ibig sabihin and how it applies to us. So Lord, we just commit our time or this time of meditating on the Word of God to you and to your presence and power. So Lord, we open up our hearts. Speak to us, Panginoon. At gabayan niyo po ako, dear Lord, that I may be able to expound your Word or explain your Word faithfully, clearly, and truthfully, Panginoon, sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen and amen. So, basically, itong mga Hudyo, itong imaginary Jew that Paul is talking to, no? Of course, hindi naman talaga totoong merong Jew doon, nakausap siya. But he is using yung technique, no, na nung panahon ni Paul is very, very common, you know, yung diatribe, as it is called, no, technically, diatribe. Yung parang mayroong kausap, tapos may nagtatanong siya, gano'n. That's a strategy for trying to explain a point, okay? And Paul uses that, okay? Basically, yun ang ginagamit niya. Now, we're talking about God's wrath and His character. Now, itong imaginary Jew na to is basically objecting, no? Or naglalabas siya ng objection dun sa point ni Paul, no? And he's been basically saying, in effect, na both Jews and Gentiles are guilty before the Lord. At walang sino man can justify himself before God. And we have seen that, no? Starting in chapter 1, verse 18, up to the last verse, chapter 2, so far. Na yun talaga yung point ni, ano, ni Paul. Over and over again, you know, nire-repeat niya yung kanyang basically accusation or indictment na lahat ng tao, kahit mabait ka pa, kahit sino ka pa, we're all guilty before the Lord. Now, having said that, siyempre, yung mga Hudyo na i-imagine ni Paul would be thinking or having some questions in their minds. And if we are going to summarize it, basically, nai-stumble sila doon sa how to reconcile yung God's wrath na sinasabi ni Paul with what they know to be God's character. Kasi pag Hudyo ka, you know, it's like para sa iyo yung righteousness of God is equal to yung kanyang faithfulness to His covenant people. May kinalaman to sa, yung kumbaga, yung God's commitment to Israel na unlike sa ibang mga nations na hindi favored, basically, pagdating sa Israel, parang God is, you know, has a special treatment sa kanila. No? Even though, ang totoo niyan, even through the history and the prophets have repeatedly warned Israel na yung pagiging people of God will not shield them from God's judgment if they continue in sin. Anyway, yung sa mga other Jews, you know, parang they find it difficult to reconcile yung the wrath of God and then yung the faithfulness and, you know, yung righteousness of God. Kaya, here's what we want to do today. We want to answer the question now, why we should not stumble concerning God's wrath. In other words, maring nahihirapan ka emotionally, hindi mo ma-arok siguro, may isip na God could be wrathful, no? Samantalang sa isip mo siguro, God is a loving God, God is a kind and faithful God. So how could it be na meron siyang poot or wrath? Okay, so we want to understand that through the writing of the Apostle Paul kasi he's addressing that. So there are two reasons dito that Paul is basically trying to answer yung Jew sa imagination niya who's asking this question. Basically, he gives two reasons why yung God's character should not be parang perceived as parang inconsistent, no, with his wrath. So the first reason that he gives is this. His faithfulness or God's faithfulness is not altered, even though it's true that he's pouring out or he's revealing his wrath, no, upon all creation because of all the ungodliness, you know, and the wickedness of people in suppressing the truth. As we have seen, no, sa Romans chapter 1, verse 18 and following. Pero sabi niya, even if God's wrath, no, is revealed, it doesn't mean na ito ay parang nag-aalis na o parang binabaliwala na yung kanyang pagiging faithful. And so we can read that from verses 1 to 4. Kasi for the Jew, yung faithfulness of God is equal to the righteousness of God. Meaning, because God is faithful sa kanyang covenant sa Israel, he would not actually judge Israel. No, he would not actually judge the pious Jew. So let's read these words of the Apostle Paul. Sabi niya, what advantage then is there in being a Jew? Or what value is there in circumcision? Which is the same thing, of course. The Jew is also called the circumcision. In other words, he's reiterating a possible question sa puso ng isang pious Jew who's asking, so ano, wala nang kwenta yung pagiging Jew? Well, ang sagot ni Paul, very emphatic, sabi niya, much in every way, you know. First of all, they have been entrusted with the very words of God. In other words, what Paul is not saying is that being a Jew is wala nang kwenta. He's just saying that being a Jew does not mean na you can excuse yourself or you can escape God's judgment and so therefore di mo kailangan ng salvation simply because Jew ka. So, but he's not saying, in effect, na being a Jew means nothing to God. No, that's not his point. Kasi when you read yung mga preceding verses, baka yun ang maging understanding mo because he is basically saying, first for the Jew, then for the Gentile, paulit-ulit sinasabi niya na, you know, if a person sins under the law, no, then he will perish under the law. If a person sins apart from the law, then he will be judged apart from the law and so forth and so on. So, sa madaling salita, it might be construed na a Jew has no advantage whatsoever. Now, Paul disagrees with that kasi nga sabi niya, in the first place, of course, there are many blessings, no? Pero isa sa mga primary blessing ng Israel is that sa kanila ay pinagkatiwala yung revelation of God or the very words of God. So sa kanila ay pinagkatiwala yung revelation of who God is, the true God, the one true God, at anong purpose niya sa mga tao. So that is a great advantage. Hindi mawawala yun. Sila pa rin yung conduit. Sila pa rin yung, in other words, parang ginamit ng Panginoon na instrumento para ipaalam sa lahat ng tao ang pagka-Diyos, no? Ng Diyos, okay? And is His will for everyone. So through the Old Testament, you know, in all the different stories and narratives, etc., ni-reveal ni Lord ang kanyang character and kanyang katotohanan, and that will never change. So therefore, kahit na tayo ay hindi Hudyo, meron tayong ikangautang na loob, no, sa mga Hudyo, and we must remain to be positively inclined toward them at hindi biased toward them. Kasi nung araw nagkaroon ng bias, no, toward the Jews dahil nga yung mga Christians feel na yung mga Jews ay sila yung nag-reject kay Christ. Yun ang nangyari no World War II, no? Yung nagkaroon ng Holocaust. So many Jews died because they blamed the Jews for killing the Messiah. But anyway, oh, bago tayo mapalayo doon, no? Sabi niya sa verse 3, what if some did not have faith? Will their lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? Kasi yung pinaka parang nasa isip ng Hudyo, no? Paano na yung mga promises ni Lord sa Israel, etc.? So he says, what if some did not have faith? So he's now referring to those na kinokondem niya, those who nagsasabi na they have the law, they are the teachers of the law, pero they're violating the law, etc. So they do not have faith. So sabi niya, will their lack of faith nullify God's faithfulness? Wala na bang silbi yung mga pangako ng Panginoon? Now, ang answer ni Paul is very emphatic again. Sabi niya, not at all. Let God be true and every man a liar. No, sabi niya. As it is written, so that you may be proved right when you speak and prevail when you judge. So Paul is quoting Old Testament scripture na nagsasabi na God will always be basically faithful. Yun ibig sabihin talaga ng true. No? God is, let God be true. Okay? Truth means reliable, you know, faithful. Galing sa Hebrew word na emeth. No? So, ibig sabihin, God will always be reliable sa kanyang mga pangako. He will not be untrue to himself. Kahit na nga tayo ay unfaithful, he will remain faithful. Okay? Because that is his nature. Okay? At the same time, sabi niya, in every man a liar. So, ang mga tao, basically, yeah, they can actually lie and mislead and deceive, etc., but not God. So, sabi niya, as it is written, so that you may be proved right when you speak and prevail when you judge. In other words, yung wrath ni God towards sin, no, is not inconsistent with his faithfulness. So, yung faithfulness niya is not altered at all. Hindi nawawala yun, even though God is revealing his wrath. So, para sa atin, you know, huwag tayong ma-stumble o pag iniisip natin, paano yun? Parang God is revealing his wrath. Ibig sabihin ba noon na yung mga promises niya are no longer true? No, his promises are still true, no, in the Bible. Okay? But remember, yung promises niya also include yung mga warnings niya, especially to the people of Israel. Now, if you read the last part of the book of Deuteronomy, yung blessings and curses, God promises Israel, no, that they would be blessed if they walk in with the Lord or in the Lord. Tapos, at the same time, nag-warning din siya na if they worship idols and all of that, then God's judgment will come upon them. Walang exception yun. Walang favoritism just because sila ay people of God. Pero one thing na kailangan natin ma-recognize, hindi nawawala ang faithfulness ni God kahit na when He's dealing with sin. So, kung i-apply natin sa buhay natin yan, if the Lord is rebuking us or telling us na may mali sa buhay natin, it doesn't mean na yung kanyang character is no longer parang reliable. He's still faithful. We can still come to Him. In fact, yun ang dahilan why we can come to God and ask for forgiveness and be reconciled with God. No? So, sa madaling salita, you know, this is a very important truth. Huwag natin isipin na yung wrath niya o pagkapot niya towards sin is somehow inconsistent, no, sa kanyang character. Secondly, no, yung kanyang justice ay hindi nagbabago. His justice is not altered, no? It remains, you know. He's still just, you know. He's not unfair. He's not, you know. He's the judge of the world, no? Now, tingnan natin sinasabi ni Paul sa verse 5 to 8. Sabi sa verse 5, but if our unrighteousness brings out God's righteousness more clearly, what shall we say? That God is unjust and bring His wrath on us? I'm using a human argument. So, kumbaga, parang kinokote niya yung nag-o-object na basically saying na, di ba, lumalabas nga lalo yung God's righteousness sa pamamagitan ng unrighteousness ko, no? So, parang, di ba, dapat wag niya akong sisihin o wag siya magalit because tinutulungan ko nga ang Panginoon para lalong lumabas yung kanyang righteousness. Parang ganun yung argument nila. You know, certainly not, sabi ni Paul. Again, emphatic na naman siya. If that were so, how could God judge the world? In other words, you know, parang nagko-complain yung ano na parang hindi yata just si God in judging people. Kasi yun nga, eh, di ba, lumalabas yung kanyang glory all the more habang ang mga tao are, you know, becoming more sinful. Now, verse 7, sabi niya, someone might argue, if my falsehood enhances God's truthfulness and so increases His glory, why am I still condemned as a sinner? So, itong mga argument na ganito, na parang basically, they're saying na, you know, talagang mabait si Lord, hindi niya ako dapat i-judge, you know, kasi actually, di ba, tao lang ako eh, no? Parang gano'n ang kanilang mga reasoning. Now, verse 8, why not say, as we are being slanderously reported as saying, and as some claim that we say. So may mga tao marahil na nag-a-accuse sa kanya, mostly siguro mga Jews ito, na lumalaban kay Paul. Let us do evil that good may result. No? Yun, parang kinu-quote niya sila. Now that's you know, yung reasoning na basically, you know, okay lang yun kasi kumbaga mabait naman si Lord, eh. Parang gano'n kaya apply natin, no? So their condemnation is deserved, yun ang sabi ni Paul. Kasi yung mga tao parang iniisip nila na, you know, kung talagang loving si Lord, mabait siya, and just siya, and alam naman niya tayo mga tao, marupok tayo, he should not judge us, no? But here's the truth na sinasabi ni Paul, eh. God's justice is actually not altered, and all the more it is revealed, no? When he, kumbaga, pours out his wrath against the sins of the world. Minsan kasi yung mga tao nagja-justify ng sarili nila. Well, kasi nobody's perfect naman, eh. But they don't understand, no? As far as God's holiness and justice is concerned, he has to deal with that sin. And yun nga yung dahilan why kailangan natin ng Savior. So, the wrath of God is not consistent sa kanya. I mean, it's not inconsistent sa kanyang faithfulness. Hindi nagbabago. Hindi rin nagbabago ang kanyang justice. Okay? Sa madaling salita, God's wrath does not alter His unchanging character. Huwag natin parang ipaglaban yung idea ng God's love and mercy and kindness. And then, ilalaban natin yung God's wrath, no? Or anger toward sin, at sabihin natin, hindi pwede mangyari kasi mabait naman si Lord, eh. Diba? Maawain naman siya, eh. Well, God, no, bilang judge and bilang faithful, no, will deal with sin sa buong mundo. That's why there is Judgment Day, balang araw, where everyone will stand before God. And there is no escape. Hindi mo pwedeng sabihin, hindi, mabait naman ako, eh. O kaya hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na, hindi, alam ko yung Bible, eh. Tinuturo ko nga sa mga tao yan, eh. Or, hindi, religyoso naman ako. Lagi ako nagpe-pray. Basically, what Paul is saying, the wrath of God is consistent sa kanyang character. It is consistent with who He is as a holy, faithful, righteous God. Hindi siya contrary sa kanyang character as God. So, wag natin ipaghiwala yon. Yes, God is loving and merciful, but at the same time, He's going to deal with sin justly and fairly. Kaya wala tayong pwedeng idahilan doon o di tayo pwedeng tumakas doon. All we can really do lang talaga is acknowledge na this is who God is, no? God is kind and loving and compassionate and merciful and all of that. Pero He will deal with sin. He would judge sin in the world. Kaya nga kailangan natin ng kaligtasan, mga kapatid. I know for the past few days, yun ang laging theme natin. But it's really worth repeating, no? Especially sa ilan sa guro sa atin, na minsan mas pinaprioritize natin yung love ni Lord, yung mercy niya. Kaya pag nagkakasala tayo, parang sinasabi natin na, well, you know, maawain naman si Lord. He will be merciful to me. Hindi naman niya ako pababayaan. You know, alam naman niya marupok lang ako. You know, all that kind of reasoning is contrary to the truth. Okay? So, even though it's true na, for example, kung i-apply natin sa Kristiyano, yung totoong Kristiyano talaga, of course, God has promised salvation to all those who believe in His Son, Jesus. But if you reject His truth and you continue to parang live your life contrary sa kanyang kalooban, well, you will suffer the consequences of that. At hindi mo pwedeng i-reason out na hindi mabait naman si Lord. Eh. You know? That's why we should work out our salvation with fear and trembling, sabi ni Paul sa Philippians chapter 2. Verse 12, no, and 13. In other words, hindi tayo pwedeng magdahilan. Kasi parehong totoo yun. God is merciful and loving and kind and, you know, compassionate. But He's also holy and just. And He will deal with sin. So, nawa magkaroon tayo ng tamang pagkaunawa about the character of God. This is what He has revealed in His Word sa atin. Of course, it doesn't mean na pag nagkamali ka, you know, parang kikidlatan ka na. God is working in your life. But we're talking about, you know, yung attitude na parang binabaliwala mo. For example, if you're living a sinful life and God is using various means to turn you from a life of sin in order for you to repent and all of that, pero nire-reject mo repeatedly, well, you cannot, you know, parang claim na, well, mabait naman si Lord. Eh. You will suffer the consequences of that because God is holy, is also holy. Hindi lang siya loving and faithful, no? Diba? Faithful, and He is also the judge, ano, of all mankind. There is no excuse. Kaya, again, it doesn't mean na parang matatakot tayo pag nagkamali o nagkasala tayo. But it does mean na magkaroon tayo dapat ng pagpipitagan sa Diyos, no? Reverence toward God, because we cannot mock God. Okay? Ang ibig sabihin, you cannot parang say na, well, God is good, you know, so I'll just live my life in sin. Because God, no, is also just and holy and righteous. So He will deal with that, no? He will give you over the stubbornness of your heart. So if you're listening right now and you are living in sin and sinasabi na sa iyo ng Panginoon, repent from that. Stop that. Okay? So let's say you are doing something na, ano, na contrary to His will for your life. Like say addiction or something, di ba? Or you are in a relationship that does not glorify God, or you are stealing, or you are parang living a life of wickedness. And God is sending, you know, all kinds of means of grace para i-turn ka from your wicked ways and back to the righteousness of God. Pero nire-reject mo nang nire-reject. Ayaw mo talaga. And your reasoning, di, mabait naman si Lord. Di naunawaan ako. Well, you know, you might wake up one day, no? Na you would reap the consequences of what you're doing. So, for example, if God says na, don't pursue this relationship kasi it is not honoring to God. Pero pinursu mo pa rin, tuloy ka pa rin. And then later on, you would suffer the consequences of that. So don't blame God. Don't say, Lord, kala ko ba mabait ka? Kala ko ba loving ka? No, He has already told you over and over again to repent from that. So just as an example, no? Okay, if you're indulging in sinful lifestyle and God says, no, stop that, repent from that, pero tuloy ka ng tuloy. So until one day, you realize that God's wrath has come upon you. And don't say na parang, oh, kala ko ba faithful si Lord? Kala ko ba mabait siya? Kala ko ba He's loving? Yes, He is all of that. But He's also holy and just. So tayong lahat po ay manalangin. Dear Lord, tulungan niyo po kami, Panginoon, na hindi magkaroon ng false image sa puso namin about who God is. Lord, help us na wag lang namin isipin that You are loving and kind and compassionate, which is true. But also help us to have the fear of the Lord. You are also holy and just. So help us, Panginoon, to respond faithfully whenever You are correcting us and showing us our wicked ways. Tulungan niyo kami, Panginoon, to repent, to turn from sin and to God's grace again. Because You are faithful, Lord. You will accept us, You will forgive us, You will cleanse us. So, Panginoon, tulungan niyo po ang lahat na nakikinig ngayon to recognize itong consistency of who You are, Panginoon, as You have revealed Yourself in Your Word. May we work out our salvation with fear and trembling, knowing that it is You who is at work in us. May we respond faithfully, Panginoon, sa correction mo. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.